methenamine for urinary tract infections. What is methenamine? Methenamine is a structure which is a bridged ring system. Let us count the carbons here. All the carbons present as CH2 here. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, and fourth carbon. And you can also observe fifth carbon between these two nitrogens and sixth carbon between and the two nitrogens. So totally six carbons are present as methylene groups. And similarly, how many nitrogens are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it has four nitrogens. Therefore, the name of this methenamine is also called as hexamethylene tetraamine. So six methylene groups with four nitrogens. This drug is also well known as urotropin, as it is used to treat the urinary tract infections. So methenamine, here the nitrogens are acting like the bridgeheads, which are common to the two or more rings. Now we have to start the numbering from any of these bridgeheads. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Once we complete the numbering to the main chain, then we have to complete the numbering to the what are the carbons within the bridge. So this is 9 and this is 10. So totally it is having the 10 atoms, so it is called as decane. And here the carbons are replaced by nitrogens at the first, third, fifth, and seventh positions, so it is called as 1,3,5,7 tetraazar. And finally, the ring system is tricyclo because three cycles are fused, and the bridge can be represented as 3.3.1.1 3,7. So this is the name of the methenamine. Now, how the methenamine acts? Methenamine, when it is administered into the body, it reaches into the urine, and when the urinary pH is acidic in nature, so that pH is less than 5.5, then methenamine is going to be broken down into the two fragments. So one of this fragment is the formaldehyde and another one is the ammonia. Now this formaldehyde has bacteriostatic effect and it inhibits the bacterial growth in the urine. In this way, methenamine acts as a source of formaldehyde, which inhibits the bacterial growth in the urine. And to increase the efficiency, methenamine is given as its salts like the mandelic acid salt or hippuric acid salt. And in order to render the urine acidic in nature, sometimes methenamine can also be given along with the ascorbic acid. So this ascorbic acid renders the pH of the urine to the less than 5.5, where the methenamine can split into the formaldehyde to produce its bacteriostatic effect. What is the dose of methenamine? Methenamine is available in two doses, 500 mg as well as 1000 mg. And as already we have seen, it is given as its salts. So methenamine mandylate, otherwise methenamine hippurate. So any of these salts can be given, and the frequency of dosing depends on which type of salt is given for treating the urinary tract infections. So it can be given either twice or four times daily as per the condition. What are the side effects of methenamine? So one of the important side effects is the skin rashes, which can be observed after treatment of this methenamine. And sometimes you can also observe hemorrhagic conditions in the urine. A small blood can be present in the urine. And pain during urination is one more problem that is reported by the long-term use of the methenamine. And apart from these side effects, methenamine can also produce some of the common side effects like nausea and vomiting, diarrhea, as well as reduced appetite. So these are the side effects of methenamine. So what are the clinical uses? Methenamine is only confined to treat the urinary tract infections. It is not suitable for any other type of bacterial infections. It is only used for urinary tract infections. it has some advantage over the other antibiotics, because antibiotics can get the resistance, but the methenamine, as it is converted into formaldehyde, it has the less resistance towards the its therapeutic action. Another advantage is that it can be used for long term as a prophylactic. So it can prevent the urinary tract infection and can be given for the longer periods. At the same time, methenamine is having few of the limitations. Methenamine converted into formaldehyde, which may produce some toxic effects in the body. Its action is confined to the low dose. So if any toxic effects of formaldehyde are observed, the drug should be withdrawn. And second limitation is that it is not suitable for the acute treatment, as the methenamine is going to inhibit the growth of the bacteria. So it is not suitable for the acute treatment and active infection. So before the methenamine is used, any antibiotic is given to suppress the bacterial infection, and this is then further maintained by methenamine. So methenamine alone is not effective, and it is only used for the prophylactic purpose as well as for the chronic conditions. So that's about the methenamine, one of a drug which simply converts into formaldehyde and inhibits the urinary tract infection.